In my previous video, I've shown you how to draw a reverse animated circle in Premiere Pro, but I didn't show you how to use it. One of my viewers asked me on my video how he can use it if he moved the video to the right corner. So I'm making this video so that people like him could also learn how to use this animated circle. Let's get started. So we go to our Premiere Pro, we go to the new item. We can go with the color matte, then click on OK. We can select a white background here, click OK, drag and drop to the timeline. Now make your timeline bigger. Now go to the pen tool, click on it with your mouse, hold your mouse key, go and select ellipse tool, start drawing. As you start drawing, hold the shift and then draw, make it as big as possible. Go to the selection tool, bring it to the middle. It's very important that it be right at the middle. Then go to the shape tool again. Here you can increase the scale, uncheck the fill, check the stroke, click on the stroke, change the color, click OK, increase the thickness to whatever you want. Then we go here, we go to the effects, we go to the video transitions, we go to the wipe, we go to the clock wipe, we drag and we drop to the beginning of the video. Then we make the timeline bigger. So after we apply the transition, if you play, it's pretty quick. So what you have to do, you have to come to the effect controls, and here in the corner you can drag this to the right to make it slower. So now if I play, it's much more smoother. As I said, and one of my viewers asked, if you move this to the corner, this effect wouldn't work. So if I play now, you can see it doesn't work the way you expect it. So it's important that it would be right in the middle. So bring it right in the middle. What we can do so that it will still work when it's in the corner? The solution is very simple. First, let's cut this all the way to this place, to the end of the transition. Let's delete this. Make sure you have a gap between the clock wipe and the end so that the ends of the circle would meet. Now we got the right cut. Then we have two ways of using this. One is by selecting the two, right clicking and clicking nest. Okay. So what we have to do next is to move this nested sequence to track V2, and then we have to go this corner, go to the project, then in here you should find the first color mate we created. Click on that, drag and drop it to V1. Now we got two layers. So the top layers is our animation. Another thing you have to do is click here again, go to the effects, go to the video effects, scroll down, go to transform, select crop, drag and drop onto this nested sequence. Now select nested sequence, reduce the scale, let's set to 25%, and then you can crop the left, crop the top, crop the right and crop the bottom until it covers just the circle. Touch the motion, click on the circle, and now you can move it anywhere you want. Let's say you want it top right corner. Now if I play from the beginning, you can see the animation still works even though it's in the right top corner. If you're planning to reuse this animated circle on different projects, the best thing to do is to go to the file, go to the export media and produce this animated circle by exporting it and then bringing it to different projects and then manipulating it the way you want. If for any reason your background is different than the background that you got the circle on, you have to use a technique called blend, but that's another topic. If you would like me to cover that topic, put that in the comments below and I can address that as well. I hope this video was useful. If it was, please don't forget to subscribe, and I hope to see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.